40 Sports presents the High School Basketball Game of the Week. Today, from Mount Vernon High School, it's the Noblesville Millers against the Mount Vernon Marauders. Today's game is being brought to you by Ivy Tech of Indiana, Dennis Office, the Fortville Merchants Association, Team Logo, Warriner Music Company, and Gowdy Brothers Boilers. And now here's Howard Kelman and Jerry Seasteen.
Channel 40 Sports presents the High School Basketball Game of the Week. Today, the Noblesville Millers play at the Mount Vernon Marauders. Hi, everybody. I'm Howard Kelman. I'll call the play-by-play. And it gives me a great deal of pleasure to welcome one of the biggest names in Indiana basketball, Jerry Seasteen, to provide the color commentary. Jerry, great to have you aboard.
Thank you, Howard. I'm looking forward to tonight's game.
One of the things we talk about when we talk about tonight's game is the flu bug has struck both teams.
That's right. Both teams the last couple of weeks have been hit by the illness factor. And tonight for Noblesville, Tony Etchison, who had only 9 points last week in his last ball game, one of the best players for Noblesville, we'll have to keep an eye on him and see how he responds tonight getting over his flu bug. And for Mount Vernon, I guess 3 or 4 players have been hit this week, and a couple of players even temperatures 103 or 104. And so from a coaching standpoint, you'd like to see this get out of the way before the tournament starts, but it should make for an interesting ball club, and I'm sure there'll be a lot of substitutions that might normally happen tonight.
Tell us about Mount Vernon. The club is ranked 16th in the state.
Well, Mount Vernon's got a very good team. They're ranked 16th in the state, like you said. They're 14-3, and they've lost all three of those games to very good teams. So they definitely could be in the top 10. I saw them play in the Hall of Fame Classic in Newcastle this year. They got beat by Gary Roosevelt, took them to the wire. And then playing the second game, they had to come back and play the consolation game against Southport and gave Southport all they wanted. So they have a very good ball club. They easily could be undefeated. I think they've lost by a total of something like 8 or 9 points for the three losses.
Tell us some key players on both teams.
Well, for Mount Vernon, we've got Gilpin, who's going to go to IU, who's already committed, and we've got Chad Kleine, who's going to go to Bradley. Now, anytime you have a high school team and you've got two players that are going to go to Division I colleges, one 6'8 and the other 6'11, you know you've got a good team. And for Noblesville, like we said before, we're going to keep our eye on Etchison. He's a 6'4 senior, and he plays a very good ball game, and we'll see how he responds coming back from his illness of last week.
All right, Jerry, thank you. We'll look forward to your comments throughout the game. We'll be back with the start of this game in just a moment. And in just a moment, we're going to pick up the starting lineups. Special thanks to the folks at Pizza Barn in Fortville. Ask about their VIP card. Purchase any size pizza at the regular low price and get a pizza of equal or lesser value for half price. Not valid on deliveries. Pizza Barn on Main Street in Fortville. Very large crowd on hand here at Fortville. Mount Vernon playing Noblesville, and let's pick up the starting lineups.
Number 32, Matt Sparks. Number 30, Bill Stern. Number 24, Aaron Monk. And number 44, Ryan White. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the starting lineups for the Noblesville Millers. Starting at guard, a 5'11 senior. Number 22, Brady Harvey. Starting at the other guard, a 6'2 senior. Number 40, Gary Duvall. Starting at a forward, a 6'4 senior, number 20, Tony Etchison. Starting at the other forward, a 6'4 senior, number 34, Jerry Powell. And starting at center, a 6'7 junior, number 54, Bob Farrell. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing our very own Mount Vernon Marauders. Number 30, John Harvey. Number 42, Mark Barnett. Number 20, Chris White. Number 10, Mike Carter. And number 21, Kevin. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the starting lineup for our Mount Vernon Marauders. Starting at guard, a 5'8 senior, number 13, Roger Huffman. Starting at the other guard, a 5'8 junior, number 12, Jeff Boyle. Starting at forward, a 6'1 senior, number 11, Alex Shank. Starting at the forward, a 6'8 senior, number 40, Chad Kleine. And starting at center, a 6'11 junior, number 50, Brian Gilpin.
There you have the starting lineups for both teams. Noblesville coached by Dave Nicholson, Mount Vernon by Jimmy Howell, and the officials, David Lee and Jim Flanagan. We're getting set for a pregame program, and let's pick that up now. School getting set for the game between Noblesville and Mount Vernon. Jerry Seasting, after 10 years in the NBA, how does it feel not to be playing?
Well, it's been an adjustment for me. You know, my body kind of told me when it was time to quit last year. I've had several injuries my last few years in the league, but this year, you know, it has been an adjustment, like I said, and I feel fortunate to get out of the league with my health. You know, a lot of guys really have a lot of health problems once they do get out. Since I played 10 years, I do feel pretty good health-wise now, so I'm just in an adjustment period right now. I'm still kind of making up my mind what I'm going to be doing in the near future, and just having a good time watching a lot of basketball games.
That's great to have you aboard. There are starting lineups again for both teams. Brian Gilpin at 6'11 will jump for Mount Vernon. Bob Farrell at 6'7 will be jumping for Noblesville. And we're ready to go here at Mount Vernon High School.
Gilpin controls the tap to Chad Kleine. 13 is Roger Huffman. Alex Shank is 11. 12 is Jeff Boyle. This is Alex Shank trying to crack the zone in the early going. Huffman, Boyle with a jump. Good job of boxing out there.
That's right. Noblesville is going to try to pack the zone in and take away some of the height advantage that Mt. Vernon has, make Mt. Vernon beat him from the outside. It looks like they're really sagging in on the defensive end. Let's see what they do on the offense.
Okay, Noblesville with the basketball. 40 is Gary Duvall. And a steal. That's Jeff Boyle. Alex Shank. Huffman in the corner. Shank playing a forward. Huffman doesn't shoot. They work the ball outside. Kevin Browning will not play. He has the flu, so Mt. Vernon will miss him. Noblesville has Tom Browning, who will come off the bench.
Mt. Vernon being very patient this time. It looks like they're going to try to knock it inside, I was going to say, but Shank took the outside three-pointer and missed.
Duvall with the rebound on the hop. 22 is Brady Harvey moving it across.
Now, Mt. Vernon's in the 2-3 zone, but they're much more aggressive. They're coming out and picking up the Noblesville guards a lot higher than Noblesville's doing to Mt. Vernon.
Duvall with the ball to Harvey. And Jerry Powell with a turnover.
Yes, travel. He tried to make a quick move to the baseline and took one too many steps right there.
So on that turnover, Mt. Vernon gets it back. No score. 6.5 to go in the first period. Boyle inside. Kleine goes up and there's a foul.
Well, that's what Mt. Vernon is going to want to do. They're going to try to knock it into Gilpin and Kleine and try to get as many shots in the paint or in close to the basket as they can.
Brady Harvey committed his first personal, and Chad Kleine will be playing at Bradley, attending Bradley next year. Will shoot two, a 73% free throw shooter, averaging 19.8 per game. And he's got the first one.
Well, Kleine's got good touch for a guy his size. And I'm anxious to watch him tonight, see how he gets his points, mostly with his back to the basket, or if he'll come out on the floor and take a lot of shots on the perimeter.
And he makes them both, and it's 2-0 in favor of the Marauders. As the Marauders press in the backcourt. And on the inbounds, a whistle.
Mt. Vernon's trying to pressure, deny the inbounds pass. And that, those are the type of fouls, though, as a coach, you don't like to see happen. You know, when a player is 80 feet from his own basket and he reaches in and gets a silly foul where Noblesville doesn't have a chance to score, obviously, that far from their own basket.
And it's on Jeff Boyle, and that's number one. And Boyle with a steal inside to Huffman, and he double dribbles.
Pressure bothering Noblesville a little bit on the inbounds pass.
You saw Jimmy Howell, the coach of the Marauders. And they rush it up, and the ball is stolen by Huffman. Finally, the shot no good by Powell, and will go the other way as Alex Shank moves it across. Huffman to Boyle. It's the big fellow Gilpin, and he can't hang on. Just a junior and already committed to Indiana University.
Good inside feed that time. Gilpin just didn't have his hands up and ready to receive that pass.
Etchison over to Bob Farrell, and another whistle. We've had our share of those in the early going. Foul on the play. Chad Kleine commits his first personal. Again, a foul there where they weren't even close to the hoop.
Right, and again, you know, both teams are in a 2-3 zone, but Mt. Vernon's playing their zone defense much more aggressive. They're coming out trying to pressure the ball wherever it was, and Kleine, as a forward, even came out and made that foul out past the three-point line.
Noblesville with the basketball. Etchison's shot blocked by Gilpin. On to Huffman. Fast break. Good spin move. What a play by Roger Huffman.
Great spin move by Roger Huffman. He had a man to beat, and he just made a spin move, reverse dribble, and got the layup.
Here's a pass up court to Powell. Brady Harvey. And nobody takes the pass. 4-0 in favor of Mt. Vernon. 5:20 to go first period.
The Millers are a little rattled right now. The pressure by Mt. Vernon getting to them. You know, when you're Mt. Vernon, you can afford to be a little more aggressive and take chances on the perimeter when you've got a Gilpin and a Kleine in there to block shots if you do get beat.
That's Gilpin. Back to Huffman. Shank. No good. Kleine is deep. Kleine again. Gilpin. And finally pulled down by Etchison of Noblesville.
Just playing volleyball off the glass that time, but they couldn't get either of the shots to go down.
Well, you really saw their height advantage in that situation.
The Millers are really going to have to make a concerted effort to put a body on somebody and keep them off that glass, or it's going to be a long night for Noblesville.
Gilpin at 6'11", Kleine at 6'8". Noblesville with the basketball. There's Etchison. Good, nice shot. So the Millers are on the board. It's 4-2 Mount Vernon, 4.5 to go in the first period. Shank, 12 is Boyle. And Huffman for three, Roger Huffman. Now already has 5 points. Little fellow at 5'8", a spark plug out there.
He's come to play tonight. Noblesville got away with the travel there.
That was Farrell. Boyle batted the ball. Huffman knocks it down. Huffman was pushed, no call. Jimmy Howell is very upset. Huffman got pushed as he was going for the basketball.
Yeah, there was a loose ball, and I think both officials were watching the ball. But Huffman and Duvall kind of got tangled up, and the ball gave him a little push. Coach Howell saw, but the referees didn't.
Noblesville with the basketball. Matt Sparks has checked in, number 32 for Noblesville. The ball batted away. What defense Mount Vernon is playing. Noblesville gets it back, though. Gary Duvall out to Matt Sparks. It's Jerry Powell to Etchison. And Tony draws the foul.
Etchison with a little hesitation move there. The time before when he scored, he kind of dipped under Gilpin, and that time he made a little hesitation and got him off balance and made another good move.
Gilpin committing his first personal. So Tony Etchison will be at the line. Shooting two, fouled in the act. 3:41 to go, first period. Mount Vernon leading 7-2. Brady Harvey getting set to check back in the ball game for Noblesville, and Etchison makes the first one.
Had fast action here early in the ball game. Okay, here's the last move where Etchison kind of hesitates there. Now he goes strong to the basket and gets fouled from behind. And Etchison, we talked about early in the ball game, was sick last week. He had a touch of the flu, as do several of the players, as we also mentioned, from Mount Vernon. And Etchison only had 9 points in his last ball game. Already he's got four.
7-4. Mark Barnett, number 42, checking in the ball game for Mount Vernon. 3.5 to go in the first quarter. 12 is Boyle. Trying to be patient against this zone. Gilpin, Huffman, Chad Kleine. A little short. Sparks fumbles the basketball. Huffman for three. Picked up by Matt Sparks.
Noblesville, they can't afford to make the turnovers that they're making right now if they want to stay in this ball game here at Mount Vernon's home court. You've got to take a little bit better care of the basketball. There's another turnover. Huffman, he's all over the place tonight here in the ball game.
Huffman with a steal, and Brady Harvey commits his second personal foul. 3:01 to go, first quarter. It is interesting with all the turnovers that Noblesville's committed, they're only down by 3 points.
That's right. Mount Vernon's struggling a little bit also on the offensive end, so they haven't been able to capitalize on a lot of these turnovers. But if Noblesville continues the turnovers at the rate that they are, I'm sure Mount Vernon's going to be scoring a lot of layups here shortly.
Chad Kleine will inbound for Mount Vernon. Into Roger Huffman, who already has starred in the early going. Kleine, loop for Gilpin, but he threw it too high. Boyle's got it. Here's Kleine. And drops through. Chad Kleine with his first bucket. He has 4 points. 9-4, Mount Vernon. Duvall. 22 is Harvey. Hawked by Huffman. As Jerry pointed out, tough, aggressive defense by Mount Vernon.
Noblesville still having a hard time. Mount Vernon not hesitating to come out and double-team anybody with the basketball up there on the top of the key. It was a good pass by Etchison.
Harvey. And Kleine with the rebound. Here's Huffman. Free man in the corner. Barnett doesn't shoot, though. Boyle to Huffman. Kleine, they throw it cross-court. Boyle for three. Long. But the rebound by Kleine, nice jump, tough handle.
Great job by Kleine getting defensive position. He was on the perimeter when that shot was taken and worked his way underneath the basket to get the rebound and then with a nice little reverse layup underneath the basket.
So it's 11-4, Mount Vernon, with a minute 50 to go in the first period. Duval racing and a good defensive play by Kleine who stuck his hand in to knock it out of bounds.
And Noblesville's got to be a little more aggressive when they're attacking this press, just like they did that last time, because if they continue to walk into these traps, that's when they're making the mistakes.
Brady Harvey will inbound. Out to Gary Duval. Here's Harvey. And Kleine pulls the rebound down. Huffman will move it across.
Excuse me, Howard. Noblesville's not getting any second shots as Mount Vernon just controlling their own defensive board.
Barnett moving the ball crisply. Huffman for three. Edgerson going up, and he is fouled by Jeff Boyle. Number two on Boyle. Non-shooting foul. A minute 26 to go, first period, 11-4, Mount Vernon. Edgerson will inbound.
You know, Mount Vernon's got the big height advantage in the game tonight, but they also look like they're the quicker team, so that spells trouble for them.
Well, they pushed the ball up. Noblesville did that time very well, but lost control at the end, and it's off the hands of Bob Farrell.
I think they're going to call Farrell for a foul.
He's whistled for the personal. That time they did beat the press.
They did, and I think they need to continue to try to beat it up and get some three-on-twos or two-on-ones because they're not getting a whole lot out of their set offense at this time. So they need to beat the press and try to get some shots out on their offense that way.
Alex Shank. Here's Chad Kleine. Barnett down low. Shank. Good move along the baseline by Alex Shank, his first bucket.
Really was a good move by Shank, and he just kind of hung in the air as he drifted towards the basket and laid the ball up nice and soft.
13-4, and again they beat that press. And the shot is missed by Jerry Powell. Here's Etchison. Tony Etchison, second bucket.
Etchison's got all six of their points. They need some offense from somebody else. He's got two buckets and two free throws, and that accounts for all six of Noblesville's points at this point.
13-6, Mount Vernon, clock running. They may play for the last shot of the period. 25 seconds to go.
Huffman. Noblesville, they're looking at the bench and deciding what to do. I think they're going to switch into a 1-3-1 trap right now.
15 seconds. Kleine, Huffman, loop for Gilpin, and he jams it through. And it counts in a foul.
And Mount Vernon did a great job of bringing Noblesville out of that tightly packed 2-3 zone. They came out into a 1-3-1 and tried to trap the ball. But when you've only got one guy underneath and you're trying to guard a 6'11 guy like Gilpin, you're in trouble. As we saw, he got the dunk and a chance for 3 points.
Chris White checking into the ball game for the first time. Gilpin at the line as Jerry Powell committed his first personal. Gilpin is shooting 61% from the free throw line this season. 9 seconds remain in the first period. And the rebound to the big fellow, Bob Farrell. Let's see if they can get a shot away. Duval racing up court. And they call it a player control foul as he just leaned in.
Good call. Duval got in a bad spot where if he went straight up, he was going to get the shot blocked. So he tried to draw the foul, but he initiated all the contact. The referee made a good call, which was charging.
2 seconds to go in the first period.
Look for a long pass here.
Barnett to Huffman, off the glass. That's the end of the first quarter. The score after one, Mount Vernon 15, Noblesville 6. Back with period two in just a moment. Howard Kelman and Jerry Seasting ready with period number two here at Mount Vernon High School. The Marauders leading the Millers 15-6.
Mount Vernon's got off to a very good start. Noblesville's really kind of lost on the offensive end. They're having a hard time dealing with the height and speed that Mount Vernon has. And I think if they can get the ball down a little bit quicker, get some defensive stops and try to beat these big players down the floor, they're going to have an easier time of getting some baskets.
Noblesville with a basketball. 40 is Duval.
Well, Gilpin's out of the game right now.
And he throws it over the head.
Another turnover by Noblesville. They've got at least 7 or 8 turnovers.
Well, we've got it officially. Noblesville's got 9, Mount Vernon 3.
Okay, here's at the end of the first quarter, a good pass. This is when Noblesville came out of their tightly packed 2-3 zone and they left Gilpin all alone for a lob pass.
Opening moment, period 2. White, Huffman. And again, Mount Vernon showing the patience against that zone. Ball kicked by Etchison. As Jerry mentioned earlier, Etchison has all 6 Noblesville points. 15-6 Mount Vernon. Alex Shankton inbound.
Chris White, he played a lot at the Hall of Fame Classic. I remember him in there a lot. He didn't start tonight, but he's used a lot by Coach Howe.
He's a 6'1 senior.
Good
nice
pass.
Pass inside to Barnett for the basket.
Good pass by White.
17-6, so Mount Vernon with a chance to break it wide open here in the early going. Brady Harvey races across. Tenacious defense by Mount Vernon. Here's Etchison, but he draws the foul.
Good move by Etchison. He had the man moving and just kind of leaned into him when he went up for his jump shot. And he's been all of the Miller's offense so far in the game.
Mark Barnett commits his first personal. Tony Etchison at the line. He is 2 of 2 from the line thus far in this game. And he also has 2 field goals.
Okay, here's that last drive by Etchison. He gets the ball on the left side, goes in, hesitates, leans into his man, draws the foul. He's getting ready to shoot his second free throw. Oh, they call a lane violation on Noblesville.
So Mount Vernon gets it back, no second shot.
Just a lot of mistakes by the Millers early in the ballgame.
17-7 Mount Vernon. Huffman all the way up court. Alex Shank. There's Shank, number 11. Huffman is 13. White.
White
short. May have been partially blocked. You're right. And Etchison has the basketball. Aaron Monk, 24. And the turnaround jumper is good by the big fellow, Bob Farrell.
It's a good job that time, but Noblesville to reverse the ball from one side of the floor to the other. And that got Farrell down with a man on his hip, and he used that opportunity to get the score.
Reach-in foul there.
That was number 24, Aaron Monk, I believe, that reached in and got the foul. He saved the bucket.
Number 1 on Monk. 6:10 to go in the first half. It is 17-9 in favor of Mount Vernon.
And Coach Howe's taking the opportunity of their fast start tonight to give Gilpin a rest here starting the second quarter. And one thing I noticed about Gilpin in Newcastle is he had a very good start against Gary Roosevelt, but he kind of wore down. His stamina is not quite where it should be at this point. He needs to get a little stronger and a little more stamina. So I think Coach Howe would take any opportunity he can to, here's White on the last foul. Driving to the basket, and the foul was picked up by Aaron Monk on the reach-in.
White makes both free throws. That first shot had eyes. Second one swished through. Brian Gilpin back into the ballgame. It's 19-9.
White came in and did a good job. Now Gilpin's back in the ballgame as he's got a little blow, and he'll be getting fresh.
Noblesville with a basketball. Mount Vernon pressing. Here's Etchison.
They're finally thrown over the top. These two guys down on their own offensive end are wide open, and Noblesville's making a little bit too many passes in their own backcourt. They've got some players wide open. They just throw over that press.
Tom Browning, 52 in the ballgame for the first time for the Millers. Good rebound by Jerry Powell, but he missed the shot. And they follow it up. Browning following it up, and we've got a whistle.
Powell did a good job on the first rebound. He missed the shot, and then Browning came in for the second rebound. So good aggressive board work by the Millers.
Mark Barnett commits the personal, and that's 2 on Barnett.
foul going to the line, number 52.
So Tom Browning, a 6'2" junior who just checked into the ball game at the free throw line, shooting one and one. 5:47 to go first half. And Southpaw makes the free throw.
Well, I was hoping we'd have a game like we had in the reserve game, Howard, as it went down to a one-point victory by Noblesville, and that was the first loss of the season by the reserve team from Mount Vernon.
Noblesville won it 59-58. Gilpin with a rebound. Huffman, no whistle.
Huffman trying to draw the foul from the defense. He'd beaten him and then just tried to step in front and draw the foul, but the referee didn't go for it.
Kleine with a long one, and the rebound pulled down by Browning. There's Brady Harvey. They get it down low to Spar to Browning. Etchison. And Noblesville moving the ball a bit more crisply than they were earlier in the game. Here's Etchison. And Gilpin with the rebound. Huffman. Shank. Gilpin down low. Barnett battling. He's got it and a foul.
Good rebound by Barnett. He snuck in there. Gilpin had taken the shot on the baseline, and you expect to see Kleine and Gilpin with those offensive rebounds, but Barnett snuck in there and did a good job.
Tom Browning commits his first personal. Here is Gary Duvall checking back into the ball game for Noblesville, replacing Aaron Monk. So Mark Barnett, who is a running back on the football team and had a hip pointer, wasn't playing earlier in the year at the line. Look at the arc on that shot.
A little short.
A little high and a little short.
He shot that one like a football player.
Extra point at that? Through the uprights?
Here's Noblesville. If they go down the sideline and pass over that press, they're going to be successful. If they try to dribble it up and dribble into those traps, they're going to suffer all night long.
Think about using a press like that. You either look very good if it works or very bad if they beat it. No in between.
You're exactly right, Howard. Here's a three-point shot. Good.
Brady Harvey.
Finally got an outside shot. They can bring Mount Vernon out of that zone a little bit if they can make some more shots like that.
So it's 21-13 Mount Vernon. 4:15 to go in the first half. Roger Huffman with the ball. There's Chad Kleine, who hasn't been that much of a factor here in the early going. And traveling on Alex Shank. So Noblesville gets it on the turnover. Jimmy Howell, the coach of Mount Vernon.
And Noblesville's got a chance to cut it to six here. There's that pass. Another one cross court that just almost hurt a couple people in the third row there.
Jerry Powell threw it. What's your feeling on the cross court pass? It's a dangerous pass, but it is effective at times.
It can be, and especially in this type of situation where you've got two guys on opposite ends of the floor and only one guy in the middle. That player was really open. He just put too much on it.
There's a cross court pass stolen by Browning, and Brady Harvey has the bucket.
Noblesville's battling back here. They're doing a good job of keeping their poise. They can just cut down on their turnovers. They can make a ball game of this.
Huffman penetrating the defense. There's Gilpin back out to Kleine. Five quick points by the Millers to get back into this game. They're now down by six. Barnett.
Another travel.
He walks again.
Barnett was wide open. He checked to see where the defensive man was, and when he did, he shuffled his feet.
Here is White, Chris White, checking back into the ball game. Jimmy Howell talking to Barnett.
Noblesville's done a good job of keeping Kleine and Gilpin both in check offensively. The thing that's hurt them is their own offense.
Duvall. And Gilpin has it. Here's Huffman. Both teams playing with intensity. Huffman. Barnett is free. Long with the shot. And Brady Harvey comes away with a basketball. 3 minutes to go in the first half.
Harvey's made two or three nice plays in the last minute and a half to help Noblesville get back in this ballgame.
Here's Harvey. And a whistle, they call the block.
Good job by Harvey again to split the defense. And here's that last play where Harvey comes in, stops, recognizes where the defense is, lets him go by and shoots the layup.
Going to the line, number 22, Brady.
And Harvey's at the line.
Chris White committed his first personal. Brady Harvey is a 5'11" senior. He has 5 points. Mike Carter checking into the ball game for Mount Vernon as Mark Barnett gets a breather.
Mount Vernon extends their defense so far out. Harvey and a couple other Noblesville players need to do exactly what he did this last time, and that's split that those two guards that come out way past the three-point line and get in there towards the free throw line. We can either get a shot or make a dish.
Brady Harvey with the first free throw, 21-16. He's got the second one, and the Millers now have reeled off 7 consecutive points and are within 4 with 2:45 to go in the first half.
And they finally found some offense other than Tony Etchison.
That's the key. He had all their points in the first quarter. They were down 15-6 at the quarter. Gilpin is deep. And the rebound to Tom Browning.
Noblesville had 5 players all in the area of Gilpin when he took that shot. And they obviously got the rebound when he missed.
Just when it appeared as if Mount Vernon might crack this thing wide open, the Millers have made a run. Jerry Powell. Nice pass inside. Tony Etchison. Gilpin blocks the shot. He didn't even jump. And it's out of bounds. Foul on the play.
Well, Etchison will learn. He's a smart player. He's not going to take the ball to Gilpin too many times, especially after he just got that one knocked down and also made a foul on the play.
Okay, so Chad Kleine will inbound for Mount Vernon with 2:07 to go in the first half. The Marauders lead 21-17. Huffman back out to Shank. There's Huffman. Shank with a long one. Kleine with the tip. And Kleine called for pushing off. His second personal.
That was a close call. At first, I thought they were going to call that on Gary Duvall. He was kind of going backwards, and Kleine was coming in towards the basket. It really could have went either way, but they called it on Kleine.
1:51 to go in the first half, and Gary Duvall will be at the line in a 1-1.
He's got a chance to bring him within 2.
6'2" in senior, first appearance at the line in this game. And he's got it.
We just might have a 1-point ball game.
8 consecutive points by the Millers, who are down 21-10. 1:51 to go, first half. White coming back in, replacing Carter for the Marauders.
And again, Mount Vernon has been completely shut off on the offensive end. They haven't been able to get the ball to Gilpin or Kleine to where they're effective. And Noblesville's really got back in this ball game by their defense.
And
there's another steal.
Steal by Duvall.
Tie ball game.
What an incredible turnaround and on the road for the Millers. We are tied at 21. Roger Huffman commits the personal. His first. So Noblesville could go ahead here as Duvall is at the line. Tied at 21.
Just a complete shift in momentum.
Noblesville takes the lead against the 16th ranked Marauders. Here's Kleine.
Gilpin wide open. He finally seems at the ball to him, and there he flushes it down.
23-22, Mount Vernon. Etchison. Well, the press didn't stop him there. Tony Etchison with a bucket. He has 9 points.
Etchison
24-23.
The last time he took one more dribble and went into Gilpin, that time he pulled up before he could get to the shot and made it.
Chad Kleine back out to Huffman. Gilpin is deep. Kleine for the basket. Chad Kleine now has 8 points. It's 25-24 Mount Vernon. 55 seconds to go first half.
That was a great post pass by Gilpin on that last play. Here's Etchison again.
And Gilpin with a rebound. Roger Huffman on the move. Good job of getting back by Noblesville on defense here.
That was great defense by Brady Harvey in the open court to shut off the lane to the basket.
Gilpin is deep for the basket. Gilpin now with 6 points. 27-24, Mount Vernon by three. Let's see if Noblesville plays for the last shot of the half. Well, they push it up court. Here's Powell. Back out to Duvall. 15 seconds to go in the half.
They're going to take the last shot, but that's the way to break that press, is just to throw over those four guys that are down on their own end of the court.
5 seconds. They better shoot it quickly. They're not going to get a good shot. And that's the end of the first half. They didn't get a good shot. The score at halftime, Mount Vernon 27, Noblesville 24. We'll be back in just a moment. Howard Kelman and Jerry Seesting, we're back at Mount Vernon High School. We're at halftime. The Mount Vernon Marauders leading the Noblesville Millers 27-24. Special thanks to the folks at Pizza Barn in Fortville. Ask about their VIP card. Purchase any size pizza at the regular low price and get a pizza of equal or lesser value for half price. Not valid on deliveries. Pizza Barn on Main Street in Fortville.